Hi folks, welcome back to the Carver's Woodshop. This is Arleen from Honeybrook, Pennsylvania, and I'm in my Carver's studio, camper studio right now. It's a good day to be in if you want to take a look how bad PA has been the last couple of days. We've had nothing but very, very heavy rains coming down. You can see it right there. It's been doing that all day long, just downpours all day long, and a lot of flooding today, so it's a good day just to be inside. I guess I won't be mowing any yards today. It was supposed to be my yard day on Wednesdays, and I can't always I can't always dictate what day I'm gonna do it, right? So anyway, today is not the day to be out there mowing the yard. So I want to show you a couple things about painting and share a couple things with you if I could. The first thing I'm going to share with you is, well, this is a new little guy that I started to do. He is a, he's called my Uh-Oh Santa, where he can sit up, you can put him upside down or right side up and see his little tassel and his hat. Now this is a prototype. This was just something I wanted to try to see how it would work out. And I'll be making one of these a little bit taller and maybe a little different idea, but that's one thing you can do. The only hard part is, where do you sign it? I think I'll sign it on one of the bricks on the top or on the bottom there. So you can do it either or. You can set it one way or you can set it the other way. So that's one of the projects we're going to do. We're still working on the sitting Santa. I'm painting him right now, and I'll do a short video on him as soon as it's done to complete that project of the sitting Santa with the sitting series that we've been doing. I think this is number 6, and then this one and the golfer will go on a DVD next, and that will be number 67. So that's coming soon. Probably in a couple of weeks I'll have that all done. If my planning is correct, it will be done in a couple of weeks. But I want to share a couple things with you. First of all, painting is not fun for the average wood carver. The average wood carver would rather be carving than painting anything, and I am no exception to that. I had to learn how to paint, and I'm going to give you some tips on how to paint these. I know I don't do many videos on it. Way in the beginning I was doing it all the way from start to finish, but I found most people were interested in the carving portion than the painting. If you ask 10 people how they paint, you're going to probably get 10 different answers. Alright, so what the thing you want to remember is doing it thin enough, heavy enough but thin enough to cover your pieces. What do I mean by that? Well, washes are a consistency of water and the paint when you're using acrylics. And these here have everything on the Santa. By the time I'm done, will have 2 coats of paint. It has a little heavy, a little lighter coat, and a little bit lighter coat, heavier coat, and then a lighter coat to even everything out. Because if you try to do it in one shot, you're going to have it blotchy. It's not going to look right and uniformed. You'll still be able to see the wood through it, okay? You'll still notice that there's wood underneath it. But it's going to be something that you're going to have to kind of learn how to do. And the consistency I use is whole milk when you mix it. You know, the consistency of whole milk is usually my rule of thumb for mixing the water ratio to the paint, because it comes out real thick out of these tubes, you know, when you get it. So that's the first tip. So coat your thing a couple of times, not just once, because if you do it once, it's going to look blotchy. Again, you want to make sure that you take off all the rough spots, anything the bandsaw hit on it, and make sure you sliver those, all those sides nice and smooth with the knife. I don't sand, because when you end up sanding it, and you sand one area more than another, it's going to look blotchy. The paint's going to adhere and get much darker, and the spots are a little rougher than the stuffs that are really, really smooth. So make sure you take off all the rough spots on your Santa, go over it a couple of times, look at it and see if there's any area you missed, and go over it before you paint. I do not seal mine before I paint, and one of the things I often do when I paint is, when I start a piece, I always work from this side to the edge. I load up my brush and I work my way to the edge. I don't load my brush and start at the edge, simply because if it gets sucked into the arm or if it gets sucked up into the hat, it's going to be minimal, and so that takes a little practice. So when you paint, you are going to load your brush as well as you can, not dripping wet, but load it up well, and then you're going to go across it and work your way to the edge. That's how I do it, and that minimizes the bleeding that you see in some of the carvings when carvers first start. You know, they bleed one color into another. That eliminates some of that. The other thing you want to remember is when you're painting with our acrylics, they dry very quickly. So when I mix, you can see there's two different colors between the red of the coat and the bricks that I have here, and I still have to put that gray line in, just like, you know, I did here. I put the gray, like the gray mortar lines in between the bricks. But what you want to do real quick is when you're mixing this, mix enough of it that you have some left over, because if you hit a little bit of white like I did, I just trimmed it off a little bit with the knife and then went back over it, and it completely looked the same, you know, was uniformed and looked the same. So, and how do I do that? Well, you see, I have a plate that's upside down now with, I was away for about an hour, a couple of hours here, and I wanted to keep my paint somewhat fresh where I left it. So this is, I'm doing the flesh portion right now. You can see there's water in it, there's two different colors in it, and it's just perfect to just start back to painting. But I have a stack of these, and what I do is I start with a stack of the styrofoam plates. I use whatever color, and then when I'm done with that color, the clean plates are usually on the bottom, I put the new plate on top and I put another color. What that does is, say I'm done with the flesh and I put it down and there's nothing left, I hit some white into the flesh, or I need to touch up the flesh, then what I would do is I go back through my stack, and I'll show you what this looks like. I'll go back, well, this is a clean plate too, but I'm trying to show you this earlier. I'll have, this is from yesterday, most of this has dried up, but if it's in the same day, you can lift this up, it will be on the bottom as well, but then you'll be able to get whatever color that you need to match exactly to go back and touch up the projects that needed that extra, you know, that extra touch up that you need to get it done. So in that way, it won't dry out right away. So when I'm done with this, I'm going to lay another plate over top, and I'm going to do another couple of different things. The only thing is, when you lift the plate off, you don't want to set the plate somewhere, because it's going to be on the bottom of the plate as well. But that way you can kind of paint for a few hours without worrying about everything drying out and trying to mix the same colors to match it. Okay, so that's my tip of the day on a rainy afternoon here in Pennsylvania. Okay, I hope that's helpful to you. Just take your time when you paint. This is like my third, maybe fourth time I'm sitting down to paint. I did about 3 hours one time, 2 hours another time, probably an hour and a half before I left today, and now I'm going to sit here probably for the next 3 hours and finish it up. But I'm doing 12 Santas, so, and some of these will be on eBay very shortly. I'm going to start listing things again. I think the chimney Santas are a big hit. The last show I was at in Lancaster, I sold everything, plus the ones that weren't painted yet got sold. And some of these are those orders that people had already paid for. So that's my idea. And I have a few new ideas for the sitting series, so we're going to continue with that. I'll come up with some other characters that we can do to keep it interesting, so you can use the same block for a lot of different projects. Okay, folks, I've got to run. Let's keep carving out there and enjoy the rainy afternoon and in the shop. Bye-bye.